between Hong Kong and the GBA markets. They are very interested in collaboration with the mainland.
Government Bill. First reading, Mandatory Reporting of Child Abuse Bill. Second reading, Secretary for Labour and Welfare. Mr. President, I move the second reading of the Mandatory Report of Child Abuse Bill. The bill seeks to ensure early detection and intervention of child abuse cases to achieve the policy objective of child protection. The Chief Executive announced in his 2022 policy address that the government would take forward full steam the setting up of a mandatory reporting mechanism for child abuse cases. Training would be provided for relevant practitioners to facilitate their early identification and reporting of child abuse cases. A cross-bureau's working group was then set up, comprising the Labour and Welfare Bureau, the Education Bureau, the Health Bureau, and the Security Bureau. The working group consulted the stakeholders in the social welfare, education, and healthcare sectors, and the relevant government advisory bodies in 2021 and 2022, respectively. The working group also briefed the panel on welfare services in September 2021 and November 2022, respectively. Stakeholders and members in general support the setting up of the mandatory reporting mechanism. The mandatory reporting mechanism is established to facilitate the early detection and intervention of suspected child abuse cases. The bill defines children as those below the age of 18. Professionals in the social welfare, education, and healthcare sectors are specified as mandated reporters. If during the course of work they have reasonable grounds to suspect that a child has been suffering serious harm or is at real risk of suffering serious harm, they must make a report as soon as possible. Failure to comply with the reporting requirement will attract a maximum penalty of 3 months' imprisonment and a fine of $50,000. The bill also provides for a statutory defense and legal safeguards for mandated reporters. As professionals in the education, healthcare, and social services sectors are specified as mandated reporters in the bill, we can cast a wider safety net for children and deter child abuses. To tie in with the implementation of the bill, the government will provide training for mandated reporters. Codes of practice will also be drawn up to assist them in grasping the principles of child protection and identifying target cases. This will facilitate their early detection, reporting, and intervention into child abuse cases and minimize abusive reporting. To allow sufficient lead time for the mandated reporters to complete mandatory reporting training and for the relevant professional bodies to review and amend their professional codes of practice or guidelines as necessary, we propose to implement the mandatory reporting regime 18 months after publication of the enacted legislation in the Gazette. With reference to the experience of mandatory reporting mechanisms on child abuse cases in other jurisdictions, we anticipate that the passage of the bill may lead to a drastic increase in the number of reports on child abuse cases. The government will increase the number of residential child care service places, and when necessary, emergency placement will be provided. We will also enhance public education and publicity to raise the community's awareness on child protection. At the same time, the government will review and strengthen the existing preventive and supporting measures. The government will give its full support to the Council in the examination of the bill. I implore members to support and pass the bill. Mr. President, I so submit. Thank you. I propose a question to you, that is, that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Members' motion with no legislative effect.